Zion, and this is the prepared food table with Wanda. Yes. Hi, Wanda.
Hi, how are you?
Yeah, I'm doing great. How are you?
Thank you. Wonderful, thank you.
And what have you prepared with the food from here?
Well, the students that I've worked with have prepared pita sandwiches, which had hummus on it. Also, the tomatoes from the garden, along with the red pepper, green pepper, and yellow pepper.
Awesome. Thank you very much.
We learned the nutritional value of all of those items, and we also added carrots. It did not come from the garden, but it was added.
To supplement.
Yeah, and they had their own lettuce. The lettuce is a variety of lettuces that came from the garden.
Great.
And so they made these sandwiches, and then they put their own choice of
dressings and stuff.
Dressings and sauce on them. And they were like, this is so good.
Yeah.
Now, we did have some that said,
I don't like the vegetables.
I don't eat that. I said, first of all, you're in this class to learn.
Yeah.
And secondly, you mean to tell me you're not going to eat what you planted?
What you grew? That's right. And then they changed their minds?
And it came out and they looked at me and, I think I'll try it. I said, I think so. It's a good thing. I said, but you're not allowed to say, I don't eat that in this class.
I'm going
to
try it at least.
I said, we're going to try what we've worked so hard.
That's right.
And so we also have frittatas. They had Swiss chard. Now, many people, including myself, had not had Swiss chard.
Okay, yeah.
And I actually taught them how to stir fry. And first of all, the process of taking the leaves, pulling the chard off, the Swiss chard off the stems. And once they were off the stem, then how to roll it, and then diagonally.
And cut it. Chiffonade?
Yes, they learned that process. And after they learned that process, they then had opportunity to taste it. Now, in it is also the red peppers, the green peppers.
That they grew. Yeah, that's what I love about this.
Yeah.
I've helped them plant these things and watch them harvest it and eat it, and then they know where food comes from.
Exactly.
It's really a miracle these days. So thank you.
You're welcome. Yeah. They had Swiss chard, and we added the spinach. Yeah. And it was stir fried in olive oil, and they have other seasonings and herb seasonings.
Yeah.
So they had an opportunity to really taste something made from scratch.
That's really great. Thank you, Wanda. Okay. I hope we continue with this.
Yes.
This is just the beginning.
Yes.
All right. I'm going to get some more shots of everything here. Okay. Got our little scale. These are some of the things that the kids have been learning. We've got the culinary class here. We've got the kids learning about beekeeping with the beekeepers visiting. They're doing garden journals. They're actually preparing the food. Here they are with their caps on. And here we have some of their produce. A little couple of beets in there. Some beets there. The kids, I helped them plant these beets from seed. And here they are. There's some bundles of herbs. We've eaten most of the tomatoes in the school, so these are ones that are left. There's some mint and rosemary, some chard, squash, eggplants, some onions, mangoes. All the cabbages have sold. We've got some green tomatoes, red tomatoes, and peppers. This is a little stand that they helped us make. Cabbages have all sold out. We've got some moringas for sale here. We have a hibiscus, a roselle, and longevity spinach. So that's it. This is Nick with Urban Microfarms with Local Food Project Partnership at Mount Zion. And I'll have more videos of this as we progress. Bye.